If we get this done, it will be historic. It will be bigger than any plan ever approved or ever. It will be the biggest tax cuts in the history of our country. And I can tell you, we have tremendous support for this.
It's going to be huge. President Trump earlier touting his plans for the tax deal. The president also teasing an important Senate vote on the budget framework, and that is expected sometime tonight. It was going to be this afternoon. Now it looks like this evening. And then that would bring the GOP closer to the point where they could actually vote under reconciliation on that budget bill. And that would move them forward on tax reform. So the president tweeted, Republicans are going for the big budget approval today. First step toward massive tax cuts. I think we have the votes, but who knows? Here now, maybe somebody who knows a little bit, Marc Lotter, former special assistant to the president and former press secretary to the vice president. Marc, good evening. Good to see you tonight.
Good to see you, Martha.
So do you know? Does he have the votes?
I think we're getting close. This is something that Republicans have been talking about for years. Mm-hmm. Middle-class tax cuts, putting more money in the pockets of American people, and cutting the corporate tax rate, which is among the highest in the world, and bringing into an area where we can grow jobs and have companies bring back trillions of dollars that they're basically storing overseas, invest it in our country, raise American wages, and create more American jobs.
I mean, do you think that the burden of non-achievement weighs heavily enough on the GOP that they will not go home without doing this?
The burden really lies with all lawmakers on Capitol Hill, because they're going to have to go back to their constituents, back in their districts, and explain to the hardworking Americans that sent them to Washington why they're not in favor of putting more money in their pockets, why they're not in favor of creating more jobs, and why they're in favor of higher taxes. And that's just not something that most Republicans, and I would even think many Democrats, are going to have a hard time explaining.
Well, the Treasury Secretary, Steve Mnuchin, guaranteed that it would be done by year's end. And what we've heard in the past few days are people sort of pushing that timeline into, well, it could be in the congressional year, you know, McConnell said, going into January. People tend to remember when you've guaranteed something, like Joe Namath in the Super Bowl. He's going to have to deliver.
Well, the one thing I can tell you is that President Trump is a leader who wants things done yesterday. And if he could have had this done on January 20th and waiting for him on his desk, that would have made him happy. So the sooner we get this done, the American people will be happy. The president will be happy. He'll get it signed. And we'll finally, after more than, 30 years, reform a tax code that is greatly in need of being overhauled.